can do this. I can do this. They will want to help.
Is this where we're meeting the Centaurs?
Well, they don't exactly know we're coming, so it's less of a meeting and more of a surprise, I suppose.
Once we tell them about the Sidgets, they'll understand why we came and they'll want to help.
I hope you're right. Perhaps they'll be able to tell that we're sincere. There's something about them that's so knowing. It's almost unnerving. I suppose they are known for having an air of omniscience. That's exactly the right word. I just... Never mind.
What is it?
It's nothing, truly. We've no secrets to hide.
That's right.
We'll simply be honest with them about what we're trying to do. They'll have to help us, won't they?
Yes, of course.
You're absolutely right. We'll meet with them, tell them about the Sidgets, and I'm sure they'll be...
I suppose you'd like a tale for your friends on the time you spoke to a centaur, and it spoke back.
No, never! We're here because we need help!
Hear up! You made a grave error in judgment in coming here, little witch.
We do not harm the young. It is not our way.
You forget your place, old fool. I'm the leader of this herd, and while you cling to our way, their kind continue to slaughter beasts like us without a care!
From what I can see, they have slaughtered no one. They will leave here unharmed.
Mark my words, Doran. If I ever see them again, it will be all three of your heads.
Foolish children. Do you know what happens to wizards who wander here? Now, follow me.
Golden Sidgets are still alive, and the poachers are after them. They know the key to finding them lies in the moonlight, but they don't know what that means yet. Please help us find the Sidgets before the poachers do.
In the south, there is a cave within which lies what the poachers seek. A moonstone. Retrieve it and place it in the hinge in the forest. I, on the other hand, must go speak with the herd. Find me after you have done this.
I don't understand. So the moonlight mentioned in the journal doesn't refer to our true minds, but to a monster. What do monsters have to do with snitches? And why is he so certain about where we could find one? Isn't moonstone all around us? Why the truth for one? Knowing centaurs, I suspect he is referring to a specific moonstone. We'll likely know it when we see it. I don't know, but I am inclined to believe him, what with his being a centaur. I am too. It is a shame how quickly he left. What was his name?
Doran, that's what the leader of the herd called him.
Well, if Doran knows something we don't, I'd rather act now and ask questions later. I can head to the library and start looking into the cave ancient. I'll let you know what I find. Revelio.
Rebellion.
Talk to me.
Indeed, Dig thought you might want to learn how to build a breeding pen so that you can breed beasts.
I don't know, Dig. Sounds a lot of work. Can't I just carry on rescuing beasts?
Rescuing and breeding beasts go hand in hand. Young beasts are particularly vulnerable to poachers. Breeding beasts here in the room will allow us to keep the younger ones safe.
I see. And what do I need to do?
First, bring a pair of beasts to the room. One male, one female. Deed suggests rescuing kestrels, as they're at great risk from poachers. Noble creatures, but their relationship with death gives them a bad reputation. They're prized by poachers for their tail hairs.
I've seen kestrels before, but where would I find a pair of them nearby?
Deke has seen some wild kestrels not too far from the Hogwarts grounds. Then you'll need to purchase a spellcraft for the pen from Tomes or Scrolls and gather the materials it requires. Once you've rescued the Thestrals and you have the spellcraft, you come and find Deke.
Let's look at what we have, shall we?
Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Let's look at what we have, shall we?
Rebellion.
You are the talk of the school since you saved Mr. Rabe and I from the Ashwinders. We have come so far. We should discuss the next steps in our plan to stop Harlow.
I've rescued the Thestrals and brought the spellcraft for the pen.
Excellent. Now, to breed your Thestrals, simply release them into the same vivarium in which you conjure the pen. Then use the pen to start the process. Come and see Dick when you're finished.
I shall. I wonder where I should conjure their pen.
Tired of the room surprises. We now have a perfect place for those Thestrals. Please let Deep know once you've read them.
I should let Deke know about the newborn Thestral. You'll be pleased to know that a little Thestral was born.
How wonderful to have more Thestrals in our world. Such misunderstood beasts.
I'm sorry that we both can see Thestrals, Deke.
Deke is privileged to see such majestic beasts, but sometimes wishes Deke couldn't. Deke is to blame.
What do you mean, to blame?
Years ago, Deke's master ordered Deke to help him capture a phoenix, the rarest of all beasts, that Master had spotted high on a cliff. The phoenix was the most beautiful beast Deke had ever seen. Deke begged Master to leave her be. When Deke hesitated to climb up the cliff as ordered, Deke had to punish himself. As Deke punished himself, Master grew angrier and angrier, and in his frustration cast at the regal bird. Deke suspects the phoenix was protecting eggs when it swooped down in fear and fury. Before Deke could reach him, Master fell from the cliff. Deke stayed on that cliffside for days, punishing himself, before Tobbs found him.
What a horrible tale, Deke. I'm so sorry.
Deke has only told Professor Weasley that story, and now yourself. Deke often wonders what became of that phoenix. Deke feels fortunate to be at Hogwarts now, helping you rescue beasts. Perhaps Deke can make amends for what came before.
Spend the entire day in this.
Lower Hogsfield still
dealing
with that?
There's something in there. I just know it. Hello. I don't believe we've met. Oh, hello. I'm Lenora. Pardon me if I seem a little distracted at the moment. Everyone thinks I'm utterly balmy. Samantha thinks I'm potty. But it's this painting. I never noticed it before. If I know Hogwarts, and I do, an empty frame doesn't appear for no reason. There's something more to this. Have you gained any insights about the painting since you've been studying it? I did discover that casting Lumos has an effect of some kind. But I'm not sure what to do next. Are there other empty paintings like this around the school? Yes, a few. This entire place is somewhat of a riddle, to be honest. If I can work out the riddle of this one, I'll know what to do with all of them. As good a place as any to begin. If I have the time, I may look. Could be intriguing. I've been racking my brains long enough. I hope you'll have better luck than I have. Do come and find me if you stumble on something. Painting that solves the mystery? Lumos. That spot must be a clue. I should look around in case it's nearby.
My family has a lot of Muggle traditions, from my mother's side.
This looks like the location from the painting. What could be so special about it? Let's get you back to your frame, little moth.
I can appreciate it.
I knew there was a connection. I should tell Lenora that I solved the puzzle of that empty frame.
Lenora, I solved the mystery of that painting.
You did? How?
I found the location depicted in the painting, and then I cast Lumos to guide a moth back to the frame.
All very logical, I suppose. Pity I was so close to solving it.
You have a knack for solving riddles. Natty's good at that too. So is Amit, although he does tend to overexplain. Well, I'm glad someone figured it out.
The moth! I should have seen that!
Remote hamlets for the Ashwinders running about.
Mild.
Revelio. Revelio. Welcome back.